Welcome to GoHCLabels.com, the ultimate and absolutely free online platform for seamless drug repackaging and label creation. In this video demonstration, we'll guide you through the process of signing up for an account and getting started with your labeling process. If you know someone in your facility who already uses GoHCLabels, they can send you an invite to join your facility's organization. Just ask them for assistance or reach out to us to help you get in. Once you have received the invite, follow the instructions in the email to join the existing organization. If you are creating a new account entirely, it's as simple as clicking the register button located in the top right corner of the website. Simply fill in the mandatory information and click submit. Once your request reaches our team, you'll receive a message via email to complete the setup portion of GoHCLabels. Remember, if you have any questions or need assistance, our friendly support team is just a call away. Now that you're in, navigating the user interface is really easy. Based on your invite and role in the organization, you may see limited tabs. Admins are always able to see the featured tabs featured above. The labels section contains the organization's collection of pre-existing labels. It serves as a platform for creating new labels, modifying or removing current labels, and printing all the labels, both old and new. In the templates section, you can create custom label designs with required fields and customize appearances. These templates can be used in the labels section for efficient and rapid production of drug labels. The stocks section allows you to add label stocks that are not currently present on GoHCLabels.com. This enables printing on a wider range of laser and thermal labels, expanding your options for label production. The print log is a queue that stores print jobs before they are printed or approved. It helps you organize and manage your printing tasks efficiently, ensuring a streamlined workflow. The optional final check queue replaces the need for a manual repackaging log. It stores print jobs for approval, allowing authorized personnel to access and approve or reject them. Additionally, information about the repackaging process is available for retrieval in the reports section. In the reports section, you can generate and execute reports for previously run print jobs. These reports can be tailored to include relevant information as required, providing valuable insights and record-keeping capabilities. To assist you along the way, we have included a help widget located at the top right corner of the screen. You can easily access it by clicking on the question mark icon. Once clicked, two options become available: Ask and Answers. The Ask feature allows you to quickly ask questions and receive prompt answers when encountering difficulty. The Answers feature provides a list of frequently asked questions and corresponding solutions that may be helpful. Prior to diving into the labels section, it is highly recommended to review and establish the organization settings. To access these settings, simply click on the widget located just to the left of your initials in the upper right section of the screen. Let's explore what we'll find there. In the custom fields subfolder, you can create fields on an organizational level. These custom fields are added by an administrator and serve as optional fields that can be included in any template or label creation process. Similar to standard fields, custom fields are retrievable in reporting, providing valuable data for analysis and reporting purposes. The invitation subfolder is where you can find all the invitations you have sent out previously. Invitations remain in the section until they are accepted. If an invitation has expired, you can easily resend it from here. Simply click on the three dots located to the left of the user's email address, and you'll find the options to either resend the invitation or remove it entirely. In the roles section, you have the ability to create custom roles for your organization. These roles can be assigned to users when they are invited to join the platform. Designing, creating, and assigning roles can be done by organization administrators, granting them the power to allocate specific permissions and access to various features with GoHCLabels. Once created, these roles appear as selectable options in the Invite Users section. System settings will allow you to set security features, date-time formats, and selections to utilize our auto-generated lot feature, and even turn on our final check feature. Clicking on the top right bubble will guide you through accessing your profile settings, Euclid print capabilities, a PDF version of our instruction manual, and links to other helpful assets. Focusing on the opening page after logging in, we will see the label library. This may be empty if this is a brand new account. From here, we can create a new drug label at any time based on our stock selection. Any user registered in your organization will also have access to anything created and printed to streamline your facility's workflow. GoHCLabels has many pre-built stock layouts for all of your healthcare logistics products. To create a new label, we would click Create a Label on the top right of the page. Next, we select our stock. For this example, let's say we want to use the EasyGrid 6504 label provided by Healthcare Logistics. Clicking Next or the Edit Fields and Designs tab will bring us to entering in our drug information. Using the NDC database search at the top field, we can scan or type into this module to easily find the drug information we are looking for. Clicking on a selection will allow the platform to autofill the information based on the NDC. If no result is found, we can manually enter any of these fields or create custom fields to help make our label perfect. If the label is tied to a template, we can override that template as well. Moving forward to the Edit Layout section, we can modify our label once more if needed. Any changes to the design of this label will save for future prints. Let's take care of that super long manufacturer name, shall we? By clicking on Edit Layout, we click and drag the corners to shorten that specific text, or even move things around as desired. We can also swap out that barcode for something like a QR code. Being able to customize your labels in unique ways is another advantage built into GoHCLabels. Let's also add an auxiliary logo to our label. Using images saved on your computer, you can also drag and drop desired logos or auxiliary images at your leisure to give it more of a standout look. Holding down Shift on your keyboard while shrinking in the image will help make this label even more fantastic. Now that we have the label perfect, we can save or we can save and print it. We can also give it a name. Most facilities we work with will give it the drug name and strength. To print at any time, we can simply click on the label. This will bring up a prompt to add the additional information needed for printing, such as our internal lot number, manufacturer lot number, expiration dates, and again, any other fields that we have drawn up for this label from the drug information. We can also adjust our print count in this section as well. Keep in mind that this is based on our stock selection. Some labels may default to a full page for proper use with our EasyGrid system. Going through to the print screen, we can see our PDF, which is the last step to our printer. Let's take everything a step further to meet some of our needs on our labels. We can utilize the template section to create and modify existing stocks to fit our needs. Maybe we want to make everything uniform with a facility name and other features we can benefit from, like the manufacturer lot number instead of the internal lot number on the label itself. To do this, we would create a template, select our stock, and add the appropriate fields we would like shown on the label. Keep in mind, show means that we will show this in reporting. We would also need to paint these fields to the template in the customize layout section. I'm going to add our manufacturer lot to the label, but leave manufacturer expiration as a mandatory field just for reporting purposes. Editing this layout will allow me to click on the NDC on the left side of the paint screen and then click this to apply anywhere on the label. There are many other amazing features in this section, such as color options and text alignment tools. In this example, I want to align the text in the middle so the data will be perfectly centered. Now, let's save this so we can name it. I'm going to call this my 6121 standard template. Now I'd like to make one for a controlled template. As well as saving some time with our work, I can simply click the three dots on the left side to copy our last template. Add our DEA schedule field, do a couple more adjustments and a shape design. Rename this guy and I'm ready to use two templates with my new labels that I or anyone associated with my account can use. We want to ensure that these processes are the easiest part of your day, so feel free to reach out to us if you need any assistance. Now that we have been printing for the day, we can utilize some incredible features in our report section. Let's say I want a report of today's labels with our receipt label as a PDF. We can select all of our parameters from here we would like to show with the configure button. Save a copy, and once we have that, we can even export this out to PDF to print or keep in our personal records. Taking this a step forward, once we have everything how we want it, we can schedule out this report to our email whenever we would like. Activating the final check feature will introduce a new tab to your top menu bar. This feature will allow all print jobs or ones of your choosing to appear here after printing. This allows you or other members of your organization to leave notes on print jobs in digital form. These notes will also be available in the report section for later review. Let's say one of my print jobs called for a certain amount of labels, but I only packaged another number. I can simply click on the Final Check tab, click on the label, and change the quantity of those labels while leaving a note as to why this error occurred. Again, this feature is activated for all labels automatically, but if there are certain labels this is not needed on, you can disable this to those particular labels as needed. At any time in the future, if you wish to bulk edit or delete labels, you can select more than one with the checkboxes on the left side. This will allow you to bulk update labels to other stocks as well. For example, say we moved our labels from HCL's 6121 to the EasyGrid labels 6504. We can simply select our desired labels, click Edit Selected in an above top column, and from here, point these labels to another template or even stock. You can even bulk edit tabs and the final check feature as you desire. Thank you for exploring the features and sections of GoHCLabels.com. We hope this guide has provided you with a clear understanding of how to make the most of this powerful platform for efficient label management and production. If you have any further questions or need assistance, don't hesitate to reach out to our support team.